What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about deploying and configuring DNS security extension. So let's get right into it. All right, so what is DNS SEC? What does it stand for? It stands for Domain Name System Security Extensions, and it adds a layer of trust on top of your DNS by providing authentication. And it creates a secure domain name system by adding cryptographic signatures to your existing DNS records. Now, these digital signatures are stored within your DNS server alongside with your A records, your MX records, and your CNAME records, and et cetera. Now, how to actually configure your DNS zone with, you know, DNS security extension. So that's pretty easy. Now, I open up my toolset. And within my toolset, I have my Active Directory, my DNS, my group policy management, and et cetera. These are everything that I kind of manage within my infrastructure. I added DNS. So when I click on it, it's going to prompt me this. This is my first time actually accessing DNS within a workstation. So I clicked on the following computer and I added the computer that has my DNS service. So it would be my DC01 and I clicked OK. Great. Let's open up DNS. You're going to see whatever server has the DNS. We're going to open that up. And within here, we're going to open up the forward lookup zones and open up your zone. For me, it is btnhd.edu. Once you have it highlighted, we're going to right click on it and you're going to see the option of DNS SEC. Select it. We're going to locate sign in zone. We're going to click on that. We're going to get the DNS security extension wizard. Click next here. By default, it is set to customize the zone signing parameters. So I'm going to leave it as the default and I'm going to click next here. For the key master settings, I'm going to leave it as the default and I'm going to click next here. We need to set up our key signing key. So click next. We're going to click on add. And within add, I left everything as the default, but you are able to change the cryptographic algorithm. But for me, for within my environment, I left it as the default. So click OK, click Next. Next thing that we need to set up would be our zone signing key. So click Next, click on Add. Within my environment, I left everything as the default, but it really depends on your security measures. Set it up for your environment. And once you're done, click OK. Click Next. For the next secure settings, I left it as the default of 50 and 8. Again, you got to set it up within your environment the way that you want it. Click Next here. For the trust anchors, I enable the distribution of the trust anchors for this zone. So give it a check mark and then click Next. For the signing and polling parameters, I left everything as the default, but you are able to change these settings. But for me, default is okay. Click Next. A nice little summary. Click Next and we are done. And then click on Finish. Now, if you refresh the DNS real quick, I don't mean like restart, just refresh the page. You're going to see that your domain folder, right? For me, btnhd.edu has a lock. Awesome. Also, you will see like a bunch of new records pop up, and these records are your DNS key, the Next Secure 3 key, and your RR signature. So that's great. It's working. Now, next thing that we need to do, we already configured our zone with DNS security extensions. You are able to create a GPO to push things out, and I'm going to show you guys how to do that. So within here, I open up my group policy management. I went into my group policy objects. I right-clicked on it. I clicked on new. I gave my new policy a new name and I gave it the following. Now, this policy is going to actually hit the computer node. And that's the reason why it says computer. And the name is pretty self-explanatory, right? Click OK here. We're going to select our new GPO. We are going to right-click on it. We're going to click on edit. Within here, we're going to go inside computer configuration. We're going to double click on policies. Within policies, we are going to open up Windows settings. Within Windows settings, locate the name resolution policy. And then within this page right here, we need to make the following changes. Now, for the suffix, we need to enter your domain name. So that's what I added, btnhd.edu. And we need to also enable DNS SEC in this rule. So give it a check mark. Now, next thing that we need to check off is check off require DNS clients to check that name and address data has been validated by the DNS server. So give it a check mark. Once you do that, click on create. Now, once you click on create, at the bottom where it says name resolution policy table, you're going to see the information that you provided above entered here. We should be good to go. Now, if you scroll down a little bit, we are going to click on apply. Once you click apply, just close the GPO and then you're good to go. All right, so we need to apply our IGPO. So I selected my domain name. I right clicked on it. I clicked on link an existing GPO and I located the new GPO and I clicked OK. I want to place it to the root because I want this policy to hit all the OUs within my domain. Now, to validate this, I actually went into one of my workstations, which is PC02, and I went to start. I typed in CMD. I right clicked on it. I ran it as an administrator and I did the following command and I hit enter. And, you know, group policies was updated. Now, to ensure clients have the correct name resolution policy table, we could do the following. So within PC02, I opened up the PowerShell command as an administrator, and I ran the following commandlet. I hit enter, and this is basically a nice sign that indicates that everything is working properly. Now, to check the trust anchors and the trust points at the AD level, we're going to go into the DC. We're going to open up PowerShell as an admin, and we're going to run the following command and with a parameter of name, and we're going to call out our domain name. So this is what I use. You hit enter. You should get the following trust anchor state is valid, valid. That is a good sign. Now, to also ensure that records are actually getting signed within your infrastructure, let's go inside the DC and we're going to run the following commandlet, which is get DNS server trust point. We're just going to hit enter and you should get this. This is a good sign, right? Active is always a good sign. Now, there's another way to test and validate that your machines are getting what they need to get within the DNS server. You can run the following command, which is resolve DNS name with a parameter of name. And basically the name of one of your workstations. For me, I did PC02. I did a parameter of type A record and another parameter of server, and the server would be DC01. That's where the DNS server is located. And another parameter of DNS SEC, okay. Once you hit enter, you should get the following, and that's a good thing. That basically says that, you know, everything is working the way it's supposed to work. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.